Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2456. Can you use a VLOOKUP in a pivot table calculated field? Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Gell, and today a question from YouTube. Can we use a VLOOKUP formula in a pivot table calculated field? I don't think so. Not a regular calculated field. But we could use it in a measure using the DAX formula language. And I don't have a video on this, so I thought I would just quickly show this. What I have over here in the orange table is a detailed data set, store ID, date, sales. And then in the green is a lookup table, store ID, and then selling square feet. That's a common metric that we want to do. How many sales per square feet? Because you're paying rent based on square feet. So if it's a bigger store, you want to have more sales in order to justify the store's existence. All right, now, in order to use DAX measures, these are going to have to be tables. So from this first one, I press Control T to format as a table. They call it table one. I'm just going to rename it to be called data. From the lookup table, Control T, they call it table two. I'm going to call it lookup data. Out here on the far right hand side, this is new in Excel 2016, relationships. I'm going to create a new relationship from the table called data. There's a field called store. It's related to the lookup table based on the store ID. Click OK. Click close. All right, we'll just come out here where we're going to build our pivot table and insert pivot table from the data model. Click OK. And I can build a report here with store name from the lookup table and sales from the data table. All right, but now here's where I want to do the calculation. I want to take that sum of sales and divide it by the square foot for the store. So I needed to basically do a VLOOKUP here of equal this cell divided by that cell. And if I would come in and try and do this with a calculated field, there's no good way to do the VLOOKUP in there. All right, so what I'm gonna do instead is come here to the Power Pivot tab, go to Manage. You see we have two tabs across the bottom, Data and Lookup. I'm gonna build the field here in the Data table. I'm gonna say we wanna take our sales for this row divided by, right? Now instead of VLOOKUP, you know, the DAX formula language and Excel are very similar. There's a few things that have changed, like text in Excel becomes format in DAX, and VLOOKUP in Excel becomes related in DAX. So we want the related field and we want selling square feet, right? It's a lot simpler than VLOOKUP. It just says, hey, look, we've already told you what the relationship is. Just travel over to that other table and get the selling square feet. So 7,384 divided by the size of the store is $6.36 per square foot. Calculated column one, that's a horrible name. I'll rename this to be sales per SF per square foot. All right, looks good. Close. See, when we come back here to Excel, now over in the pivot table fields, we now have sales per square foot. All right, we add that in. You know what? That's not it. I mean, it looks right. Equal J12 divided by freehold. That number right there, that number's correct, 2357. But this number, 46,000, that's not doing what we want. Shoot. Okay, let's try this. Second try. We're gonna add selling square feet right into the pivot table. And hopefully this will total to 14,930. It does. Okay, good. So now we have two measures in here, sum of sales and sum of selling square feet. Now this is a little bit different. We're not gonna add it to the Power Pivot grid. We're gonna add it to the pivot table, which kind of forces it to do the calculation at the summary level. So over here on the data heading, I'm gonna right click and say add measure. And we'll call this sales per square foot try to. All right, and we're gonna take that sum of sales number, so left square bracket will get me the list of all the measures. So we have sum of sales divided by, and it's called sum of selling square feet. We can format this as a currency with two decimal places. Click OK. Get a new measure over here. We can add that in. All right, you see that these 2357 These all match, but the difference is down here in the grand total, that 3,022 is taking the 45 million and dividing it by the 14,930, the total square footage for the whole company, and coming up with a 3,022. That is a better calculation than this sales per square foot. Okay, and then the big question, can we remove this sum of selling square feet? Can we take that out? And it continues to work. All right, there you go. So trying to do a VLOOKUP in the pivot table by using DAX and a power pivot table seems to give us what we need. If you like these videos, please down below, like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below. Well, hey, I want to thank Evil Angel for sending that question in, and I want to thank you for stopping by. See you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.